that holds us all inside, where strangers are as family and loneliness can't hide. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your...
At every chance, Mackenzie Hackenberg and I would be glitter out near your desk in biology class. I'm positive that one day glitter will rain from the sky, and it will be Mackenzie getting back at us for all of the times that we gave her glitter as well. After Mackenzie's second diagnosis, I decided that she and I would be best friends, mainly because of the noise. I'd see her in the hall and say, "Hey best friend, how's it going?" And she'd roll her eyes, grumble something, but have that smirk as she kept walking. For those of you who have spent time with Mackenzie, you probably wondered from time to time if her eyes were one day going to roll out of her head, or if her face would freeze without the look she'd give when her face looked really obnoxious. But Allison taught her manners growing up, so Kenzie would never tell you how wrong you were. Rather, she phrased it very politely and said, "You're not friends."
Tears and laughter and give yourself to love. Give yourself to love. I've walked these mountains in the rain. I've learned to love the wind. I've been up before the sunrise to watch the day begin. Always knew I'd find you, though I never knew just how. Like sunshine on a cloudy day, you're here before me now.
At her brother's graduation, she gave me two letters. One of which was touching, sweet, and admitted we were best friends, and keeping that for proof. The second one was a puzzle and wraps up Mackenzie's personality best. It was witty, creative, sarcastic, and it spelled fun down the side. Reading, "F is for family, U is for you say it here, N is for no, stop lying to yourself, you do say it." See, everyone makes fun of me for how I say my age, but Mackenzie is no exception. She often asks me what language do people in Mexico speak to see if I would say Spanish, so she could giggle. She also would ask what the opposite of plants were and hopes that I would say animals, or who I lived with, so she could mock me for saying impacted my life immeasurably, and I can never describe how much she meant to me. I know that we can never forget.